One of my viewers had a question on how they can create a form in Microsoft Word that has a pre-sized box so that a user could fill it in and insert a picture. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a table in Microsoft Word and freeze it so that it stays a certain size. And then you can turn that into a form and have a form field or insert a picture into that box. So here we are in Microsoft Word, and I've created a sample form that includes a table. So let's come down here. This is a sample incident report form, and let's say that I want to insert a table that will allow users to upload photos. Maybe I need to attach photos of an incident, but I don't want the boxes in that table or the cells in that table to expand when I import an image, depending on the size of that image. So I want to kind of freeze or lock the cells of that table. So what I'm going to do is just come down here and say this section is insert photo. And then I'm going to come up to my insert tab, and I'm going to draw a table, and let's say I want to include boxes so that people can put up to 3 photos for this incident. I'm just gonna make this bold real quick. So what I'm gonna do is place my cursor inside the table, and the crosshairs come up over here in the top left-hand side of that table. I can click on that, and then it selects the table for me, and I can right-click my mouse and click on Table Properties. So from here, you're on the Table tab, go to Options and uncheck the box that says automatically resize to fit contents. So we don't want that checked, and we're going to click OK. And then now we're going to go over to the Row tab, and up here under Size, we're going to specify the height. So let's just say that we want the height to be 1.25 inches. And then what we're going to do over here is drop down and say exactly, and then we're going to click OK. And this creates a locked table so that all of the cells that I just created, since I selected the whole table, are going to be locked into that size. So now if I come up and insert a photo, the photo will adjust and fit within that box. So I'm just going to insert a picture and select one from my device. And notice that the image inserted and it resized itself to fit within that locked table or that frozen table size. So just to show you what it might do if you didn't take those steps, if you were to insert another table, for example, the same type of table, and then if we don't make those adjustments, then when we go to insert a photo, we'll pick the same photo and insert that. And notice how the image inserted as a rather large image, and then it resized the cell so that it squished those other two columns over. Now, if you want to just lock one row of a table, you can do that. All you have to do is draw your table, come up to Insert, Table, and we'll make 3 rows. And let's just say that we want to only adjust the middle row. So we can select that, right click, select Table Properties. On the Table tab, select Options, uncheck the box that says Automatically Resize to Fit Contents, click OK, and then go to the Row tab, and here's where we can specify the size. I'll put 1.25 inches again, and then Row Height is, drop down to select Exactly, and then click OK. And then that will create the locked row in the middle of that table if you needed to do that. And then the other ones would adjust automatically by default. So one thing too that you can also do is if you are creating a form, there's a content control form field that you can use that inserts a picture or a photo so that your user, once you lock your form, the user can click on that and then select a photo from a device or something like that so they can insert a photo using that content control form field. So if you wanted to do that, what you would do is select the cell where you want to insert that form field. Come up to your developer tab, and if you don't have your developer tab, be sure and check out the other videos on my channel on how to enable the developer tab, and also all my other videos on how to create fillable forms. And then all you have to do is select over here where it has the content control form field for a photo and select that. And then if you need to size this so that it is a little bit larger when the user imports their photo, you can drag the size of this to fit your space here. So if we want to make that a little bit larger, we can. And then what we can do is come up to Restrict Editing, And we can set our restrictions to allow users to fill in the form and then start enforcing this protection. And so we click yes there. It asks if you want to create a password. I'm going to skip that for now and just click OK. So now I have my form field locked so that users, all they can do is fill in the form fields here. And so when a user comes, they can actually click on that and they can insert from a file, for example, if they have the image saved on their computer. And we can select that image and click on insert. And it inserts just like that if you were to use the content control form field, and it stays within the parameters of the box. If you found this video helpful, be sure and give it a thumbs up to like it. You can subscribe to my channel and click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Be sure and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.